Joining us this morning here on Proactive London from BATM Advanced Communications is Zvi Marom, because you've just launched a new self-collected saliva-based test that can significantly, you say, improve the sample collection process and the turnaround time as well, while maintaining diagnostic accuracy. So plenty to unpack there. A very good morning to you, Zvi. How are you doing?
Good morning to you as well.
Good morning. So as I say, we're going to break all of this down. Maybe just first of all, introduce this product to us, if you would.
Yes. Obviously, last year has been quite a difficult year, and it still continues with the COVID. So a good diagnostic test that will enable to return to normal life is a must-have. And we came to the conclusion when we watched the vaccination program in Israel that vaccination will reduce mortality and morbidity, but will not eliminate the COVID threat, especially with the mutants coming. So a very good, simple to operate, but very accurate diagnostic is a must. And then we have been working on it in the last year.
When you say simple to operate, talk us through it.
Yes, it has to be simple to operate from many aspects, from cost point of view, from operator point of view, and of course, from the user point of view. So putting swabs deeply into the throat or the noses of people is inconvenient. Mm-hmm. It's in some cases impossible, like in the case of kids or disabled people, it's simply impossible, even with people that tend to vomit. And not to mention that you need a lot of trained manpower around the clock to take all these swabs. And of course, if they are tired and so on, so on, or it's difficult to them, the sample itself cannot be accurate. So all these problems have to be solved. And we solved it with our new test.
And in terms of how many people that you could potentially service, what would be the idea here? Are we talking dozens, hundreds? How would it work?
We are talking about many hundreds and more, because when you do saliva-based testing and you leave the small tube into which you have the saliva in, one person can deal with one very simple machine. No need for expensive machinery, only PCR, which is a basic element in diagnostic. Only one PCR, you can do approximately 150 to 180 per hour. And one operator, we have tested for more, but for sure can deal with at least five machineries. So one operator in a mobile place like a van or whatever can deal with 1,000 tests per hour, which is very substantial in comparison to far, far more expensive methodology that exists today.
Mm. You mentioned events there. So where are you getting the interest from then?
Oh, obviously, the tests have been developed in Italy. So obviously, cruise ship operators are extremely interested, and we are working with them. Schools is and kindergartens is pretty critical. Sport, athletic sport, and also some football. Because nowadays in a football stadiums, you don't let 100,000 people come in, but it's more spacious. You have a few thousands, and also you need to test them. At the moment, there is not one good method to it, and so on for athletic events. So we are in good shape there, definitely.
And the samples, as I understand it, they're collected by chewing a cotton ball for 30 seconds, right? And then you spit it out and you then put it into a tube.
Yes, it's very simple. You actually don't need the cotton pellet, but the cotton pellet we put in order to make it convenient and easy to use. It's the same cotton pellet that every dentist uses when you come to him. You just put it in your mouth. It absorbs saliva. You can chew it if you like. Maybe somebody that sees this interview have ideas to put maybe mint, maybe other taste into the pellet. Who knows, for children? I definitely not capable of it, but definitely it can be an option. And then you just spit the pellet. You can mm-hmm. spit also directly into the tube, but you spit into a small collector tube. We call it salivator. And then you close the lid on it and just give it to the guy that makes the test, or put it on the window, or God knows what.
And then once it's in that collector tube, how long do you then wait for?
Yes, then it's very short. You don't need extraction process. That is the process, the late, the expensive, and the inaccurate process of extracting the DNA from the swab. You don't need it. You use a very small thermal plate. The protocol is called the Yale protocol. It was invented in the Yale University. And then you put it into the PCR, and within 30 to 34 minutes, in the simplest PCR that you have, you can do something like 96 samples. So in one hour, you can do approximately 150 on, or 280 on average. And this is extremely simple, extremely easy to use. We have tested it with people that don't have any formal training. They grasp it in no time. So this is a good methodology.
And how does the cost compare to what's already?
Well, it's definitely not more expensive, definitely. And we are using our kit, which have been bought by the elite customers, which is a 5-gene kit compared with most of the industry, which is less than 3. And it's very, very accurate kit. It detects all the known mutants today, including the Kent one, the South African, the Brazilian, whatever you want. It detects all of them. And it's the same kit basically turned into saliva. So I don't see any problem with it. I don't see any dramatic price change. And you save the extraction, which is very costly. So all in all, the process should be much, much cheaper from every aspect: manpower, operation, convenience, not to mention the test itself.
And when can we get this?
We are now started to produce it. By the end of the month, we have Passover in Israel and Pascha in Europe. And so immediately after Pascha, in the beginning of April, mid-April, we will start to supply to customers.
Sounds good. Zvi Marom, thank you very much indeed for your time this morning here on Proactive from BA.
Thank you very, very much. All the best.